Rick, some of the things that you guys really hope, if they're 17 or they're 77, when you guys bring these to schools and community centers, what do you want people to learn?
Well, more than anything, we just want them to use their hands. You know, yeah. A lot of the times now we're on that, so we're mainly focused on teaching them how to work on motorcycles through failure and using their hands.
Yeah,
like you said, like it could be, you know, 77 or 17. We're going to teach them the exact same way. So,
you know, which is so interesting because, you know, we, of course, we're about to send people to Mars. But this is the way you really learn, by just getting in there and having someone show you and doing it. Because, again, doing it like this, you're never going to forget it. Right.
Right. And I think they're a lot more engaged, you know. It's easier to get them more engaged this way.
Do you see the enthusiasm from day one when you guys do the written to the day like today where they pull out the whole engine? Do you see the enthusiasm start like a snowball?
Yeah, sometimes it clicks right away. Sometimes it takes a day or two. But with this class, it's pretty quick.
Yeah. Well, that's cool to see.
Yeah.
All right. How many of you guys worked on anything mechanical before this class?
No.
Nothing? No. Okay, how many hours do you spend on your phone and how many hours do you spend on a motorcycle? Trick question. Yeah, trick question. Okay, you guys stand up so we can see your faces. Okay, so tell me something that was a bit more difficult than you thought it would be when you started working on it. Anyone?
Knowing the tools. Okay. They're all like similar but like different.
Okay, what about you?
I think definitely the engine, which we did today, I thought it was going to be a lot easier to just get out right away, but it took a lot of shifting.
It's snug, right? Okay. Same question?
Probably just like pulling little things out, like when they get stuck, you have to like figure out like hammering stuff through.
Yeah.
I thought it would just like be easy to always know what to do and like know which tools to use.
What tool goes for what nut, what bolt. Yeah, it's like a big, huge puzzle, right? And then you still have to take the entire engine apart after you do all that. So you guys, what's your system of labeling and stuff? How does that work?
We have bins that we put like all the bolts in and everything and the Sharpies to...
Okay. Are you afraid about how the whole putting together part? Or are you, now that you've gotten to this point, you're like, we got this. What, are you nervous? Anyone? Yeah.
I think a little bit. We'll see how it goes when we...
Good. You should be nervous. That nervous energy makes you hone in. All right. Good job. Keep wrenching. Yes, the Mags Mechanics wrenching right here as part of MotoGo Cleveland. So 6 years ago, I just started with six students. Now they're doing 450 a year. Greg, congratulations on that.
Yeah, thank you.
Over 25 schools and community centers they've been serving, and they are serving currently. So that's totally cool. Look at these wrenching ladies. Keep wrenching. All right, we got to go back to you guys in the studio.
That is awesome. And those girls knowing their way around stuff like that is fantastic.
Yes, it's good to know.
Yeah, that's great.
If you need to change a tire.
That's right.
Wish I would have known.
Look at them.
I know.
Right? They're geniuses. Love it. Kenny, thank you.
You're laughing while you're wrenching. Okay.